Hello everyone, welcome to Chairside. Let me just start off by thanking each and every one of you who have been watching our videos regularly. And wherever I go, I meet a lot of dentists who come up to me and say that these videos were extremely helpful. That is what it all boils down to. And as long as there's something new to learn from these videos, we always get motivated to keep continuing this. That is what in fact also brings us to the next step moving ahead in this video series, which we call Learn from the Masters. Here we bring in the masters of dentistry who achieved great heights in their respective fields, and they've also been kind enough to volunteer to share their knowledge and expertise with all our viewers. So the master that we have with us today is one of the most dynamic personalities in dentistry. He's an eminent periodontist and implantologist from Mumbai, and also one of the finest teachers that I've ever known. Please welcome Dr. Ajay Kakar. Dr. Ajay, it's so good to have you on this first installment of Learn from the Masters.
Thank you, Mahesh. It's indeed an honor and privilege for me to be here and to kickstart your Learn from the Masters series. I know this is a brilliant initiative from Chairside, which you are heading, and under the umbrella of activities that Illusion Dental does, I'm sure this is going to be a great success.
So I just want to tell our viewers that besides being a great implantologist, Dr. Ajay is also a big gadget freak. I mean, I haven't seen somebody with so much of drive. He's designing his own websites, he's making softwares and phone applications. I mean, it's just incredible.
Well, Mahesh, I have to say that you have picked up a page from the same book. I've been seeing the number of procedural videos that you have come up with and how the dentists are absolutely loving it. So I don't think you're far way behind at all. You're on par with me now.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. I mean, it means a lot coming from you.
Welcome, Mahesh.
So, Dr. Ajay, because you're here, we thought you'll be the best person to start talking about diagnosis and treatment planning for implants. Mm-hmm. So, what is it the first thing that you need to do when a patient walks into your practice with a missing tooth?
Well, Mahesh, before anything else, the first thing that I want to know is, why is the tooth missing? And since when is the tooth missing? And third most important criteria is the age of the patient. Somehow I find that people get very excited when they see a missing tooth and they miss out these simple basic facts. So this is what I look at first, and only then I start thinking about what kind of treatment plan I have to give the patient. And in case implants figures in this treatment plan, then I look at implants.
So Dr. Ajay, you mentioned about an OPG. So is the OPG the only radiographic evidence that you need to plan the case, or you also plan a CBCT?
Good question, Mahesh. An OPG is a must for every case. There is no question of even thinking of putting an implant without having done an OPG. Mm-hmm. A CBCT, not in every case. Okay. Many a times an OPG is more than enough tool for me to decide the length as well as the diameter of the implant. But there are those certain cases where I would not be able to identify the accurate size without a CBCT.
So Dr. Ajay, how accurate do you think CBCTs actually are?
Well, this is a bit of a gray area. It is generally assumed that a CBCT is always 100% accurate. And if a CBCT says 8 millimeters, it always means 8 millimeters of available bone. Well, unfortunately, that's not the truth. Mm-hmm. For CBCTs to give you accurate length and diameter measurements, they have to be regularly calibrated. The truth of the matter is that CBCTs are not always regularly calibrated. Mm-hmm. Technically, a CBCT can always be 100% accurate as long as the calibration is done on a regular basis. So just a word of caution to all our viewers, that in case they are 100% depending on the CBCT, please confirm with the radiologist or the CBCT center that the units have been calibrated regularly.
So Dr. Ajay, we also know that anterior implants or implants in the aesthetic zone need a lot of meticulous planning. So what special do you do in those kind of cases where probably you have an anterior implant to place?
Well, aesthetics is of paramount importance when you do an anterior implant. So the positioning has to be just perfect or as near as perfect as possible from the prosthetic viewpoint. But there's a paradigm in implantology which says that prosthetics dictates, but your anatomy limits what you can do. So when it comes to anterior implant placement, what we do is we rely on all the available tools for a pre planning. We have to be pre-planned in every aspect, and as I call it, not just in three dimensions, but also a fourth dimension, where we are imagining where the ultimate tooth will come and how natural it will look for the patient.
Dr. Ajay, as we speak, I'm just informed that one of my patients is already sitting in the dental chair. He has a missing tooth in the lower right six. Do you mind if we can go and examine that patient and if we can see if a CBCT is actually beneficial in this case?
Sure, why not, Mahesh? Let's go ahead and do that.
Perfect.
Okay, Mahesh, let's see this patient now. Now, we have got this patient with a single tooth missing. And as we can see clinically, the buccal bone has been compressed. So, we have got a very thin ridge. Now, clinically planning an implant in this is very difficult without supporting evidence. And the ideal thing to do in this situation is to get a CBCT done. It's only when we get a CBCT done that we can understand and plan the limitations of implant sizes that can be used in such cases. As we wait for this CBCT to be done, let's see another case where we have done a CBCT planning for implant placement. Now, this is a compromised case. Again, the ridge is very thin, but we are going to go ahead and virtually place an implant. And once the virtual planning is done, we can do the actual real life case. Okay, whenever we have a compromised case like the one we saw on the chair, we need to really plan our implants properly. Like this software which you are seeing over here, we drop an implant over there and it tells us that it is impinging on the inferior alveolar nerve. So we can virtually resize the implant, bring it down from 5 to 4 mm diameter and 8 mm length. And now it seems to be sitting clear of the inferior alveolar nerve. Let's see it in large screen. And there you see how the implant seems to be placed. But let's check it in cut section, because it's not necessary that it's correct in the cut section. So let's see the cut section, and now we can see that the implant threads are exposed. So we go back to our original file and slightly adjust the position of the implant. Now we come back to our cut section and we see that those threads are embedded inside, but we can still see that the angle is not most favorable. So all we do is just correct the angle, bodily move the implant, and there we are in a perfect position virtually. This virtual position can be checked on a 3D mandible. See how it's completely encased in bone, in spite of having a compromised bone situation.
So, Dr. Ajay, thank you so much for giving us that insight with the live case right now. You know, just to summarize, I think we've only touched the tip of the iceberg. There is so much more that we can discuss about treatment planning and diagnosis in dental implants. I'm sure Dr. Ajay himself will have so many things to tell us, but unfortunately, time is short. But thank you so much, Dr. Ajay, for getting time out, joining us on this Learn from the Masters.
Most welcome. Looking forward to many more such things from you.
Absolutely. So that's about it for today's video. Keep watching Learn from the Masters.